A little bit out of nowhere is the fact I looked at solo queue accounts, someone like Huni. Last time at Ryze was the thing, he played like 30 Ryze games. He now has like 15 Jace games coming in as a Jace top lane here. So I wonder if that's going to be a thing for Fnatic in this game.
Yeah, and Jace feels like a Huni champion as
sure.
well. I feel like
Febivent
he's
as well.
One of the players that could excel it. And it could even be a flex pick, as you said, of Febivent. Speaking of Febivent, I wonder if Pekka is going to play something with more forward aggression. Try to force a little more aggression in that mid lane to, you know, throw Fnatic off their game. We said both teams so far have been not very mid lane centric, but do Origin want to change that?
Yeah. I mean, potentially they can do it. Vladimir, as you mentioned, has been the pick often for him, but none of these teams, they don't play around their mid lane, and poor Jace doesn't even get through.
Well, you did predict it somewhat,
the
talking
prophet.
About the, you know, the fact they're playing it in solo queue. I want to highlight
solo queue, check champions.
Alistar and Thresh banned out. I want to highlight the potential of Morgana and how valuable she might be. 13 games here in summer, 11 of which have been victories across the board, with Yellow Star securing two of those himself. Ryze banned out from Origin, one left for Fnatic.
Both junglers open at this point here. Origin doesn't want to ban a jungler in the end to take away the Ryze. Don't want to risk like going in first rotation on the
perhaps
other side.
Perhaps Kalista?
Kalista is open. It's a massive pick for both AD carries. And whenever it's open normally, especially because now you can trade, you can give them the Rek'Sai, you take the Gragas for yourself. I think Kalista is a fantastic first pick then for Origin here.
Yeah, definitely Origin, since they have to snowball the early game. A lot of people say if Fnatic goes even until the mid to late game, they feel that they have the better macro gameplay, so they'll get ahead. Or if you pick Kalista early, there's a good chance Fnatic picks up Sivir. If you then don't get a snowball, then the utility
yeah.
from Sivir comes again.
It's trade-offs right here. 280 carries, two top-tier junglers open as well.
Gentlemen, you're both very excited about the flavor of the first picks, but there's three support bans. As support mains yourself, this is a strategy we've not seen employed by any of the other teams. What does Fnatic have up their sleeve, in your opinions?
We might see the third Bard in a row here, but going back to that first pick, Hecarim.
Okay.
We talked about all these picks, but we kind of forgot about Hecarim since it's so often banned against Huni. But immediate reaction from Origin say like, well, we can't pick Kalista early because then we give up Hecarim against Huni and we might not have an answer left. So I like that they steal it away from Huni, put the emphasis on,
yeah.
on what the featured matchup is going to be in this game.
And also, as we quickly mentioned, how we have this trade-off now in AD carries and junglers, because the two most picked AD carries, Sivir and Kalista, open, the two most picked junglers, Rek'Sai Gragas, open here, so you can go for a third option, which is what we've seen Soares do here. I really want to see what he can do on it. We saw J-Wall had a decent performance once he got to late game at least, but it was shut down early on.
Do you think we'll see Huni's Gnar here?
I think we're going to see his Echo instead.
Yeah, now it's easy if he's offering it.
Well, I mean, it could be a flex pick, obviously. He's gone to the jungle, he's gone to the mid lane, but Huni showed the Echo last week. Matchup into Hecarim though can be fairly tricky. Hecarim does really well into melee champions. So I want to see if it goes top lane.
Well, in terms of performances, Soaz's one-time Hecarim, slightly less impressive than Echo's one-time Huni, or Huni's one-time Echo rather. We'll need to see where that does shake up. It was the Kalista locked in. So does Niels and Origin consider locking down the Sivir, which we saw first picked in the previous game?
Yeah, I wonder what support Fnatic's gonna pick with that Kalista, because we usually see Kalista Thresh, Kalista Morgana, Kalista Alistar, but they're all out.
We've seen Leona a few times coming in from Yellowstar. Could work with the Kalista then in terms of having a lot of engage, even maybe pull Yellowstar back out if needed. And when you run Echo, in that sense, if you have a lot of hard engage to set it up for him, you might be able to time it with your W, then jumping in and you have this massive CC chain you can use. And again, we know Yellowstar is an old school Leona player, so it is at least an option. When you ban three supports, you must have something ready.
I feel like Origin wants to hide their bot lane a little bit here to wait for Fnatic to pick the support so they can react accordingly, because it's a different thing when you have to lane against Kalista and anything, or Kalista and Annie.
Well, we do see the Gragas. It was locked in there for Amazing, and this will be the first time we're seeing Xpeke playing the King of Shurima on that Azir. But Origin locking in their entire top off of the map. They have hidden that duo lane, considering all of the bans targeted towards them. We'll see what they opt into.
That's true. It can always be a little bit risky showing your soul laners early, but it's fairly safe once. I mean, Azir mid lane does well into nearly everything for himself. And we were looking a bit at Pekka's picks here. The fact he hadn't locked in an Azir at all beforehand, he's clearly been saving it. But now also take away from Febivent, of course, his most played champion in the split so far. So I like to pick up Origin, building up a fairly standard but very strong team composition already.
Yeah, I like the Azir pickup too, because we've seen that matchup Echo is into Azir before, when I think Froggen played it against Febivent. So both mid laners would be I guess, well-versed into that matchup if it comes out. I just want to see where that Echo's going. And it's a good plan by Origin because Fnatic will be forced to reveal more of their bot lane and match the jungler, which is going to be Rek'Sai, of course, because they want to keep Echo as a flex.
Whoa, this is a good read by Origin. Rek'Sai was there.
But then she wasn't.
And then you take Olaf. Okay, okay, what is Fnatic trying to build here? With the Janna coming in, clearly they want some sort of Kaidi. They want a way of disengaging away from the Hecarim. But Olaf, he's going the other way. I mean, Olaf is more or less built to just dive into the backline of Origin. Honestly, against the Sivir, he should be able to stick to her if he connects the first axe, but it's so tricky with Spell Shield, and if you miss that one, the extra mobility for her. I mean, they know, or they expect Sivir to be the AD carry locked in. I want to see what Reignover can do on Olaf here. We've seen it a few times before, but a Rek'Sai not being picked?
Yeah, this is one of the first times Reignover strays away from that. I understand that he probably wants a jungler that can stick a little more to targets because they don't have a primary engaged really yet. They want some setup, and I guess if Olaf can slow people down, then Huni can jump in. But so far, yeah. I like Origin's draft a lot
more. I agree.
They have the Azir control mage in the mid lane. They have this aggressor on the top lane that they stole away from Huni. In addition to that, they got a tier 1 jungler. They probably have the best utility AD carry in the game and an Annie to round it all up.
Yeah, and the thing about Fnatic's comp that is really just a bit weird for me is how half the composition is running one way and the other one is running the opposite way because you have some people, Echo and the Olaf, who wants to dive in towards the backline of Origin and then you have the Janna coming in. If you wanted to engage, I mean, Leona was open, Annie was open. There were different options you could have gone for.
I think they just want to keep the Kalista alive because...
It really is that, yeah.
Let's not forget, playing Kalista into the likes of Gragas and Hecarim is incredibly hard, especially when they're sped up even more by On the Hunt. And I think we're finally going to see where that Echo is going.
Well, it does appear that it will be up in that top lane in Huni's hands once more. Victor to round out the team composition from Fnatic. If there were any other team, you might be questioning. However, Fnatic have shown against power picks, against predicted drafts. Until now, they're 6-0. They've not made mistakes yet.
That's true. Fnatic has always been a very good team at preparing and having a strategy ready. Victor coming in, it's a pick we have seen a lot in Korea, a lot in China. Starting to be playing a bit in Europe. It's very safe, but into an Azir, I honestly feel like when you talk to some of the mid laners, they say this is one of the matchups they kind of want to avoid because Azir can outrange the Victor at least early on.
Now, I actually like the Azir pick to an extent because it offers a lot of wave clear to keep the early game steady for Fnatic. In addition to that, yes, he's not that mobile in these fights early game, but he has the Janna to peel for him and he does a whole lot of damage. In addition to that, the Olaf kind of counters the Annie. It was likely that Miffy was going to resort to the Annie. Olaf can just aggress in the front with the Janna shields, force the Tibbers and then, you know, Ragnarok out of that and storm down and just force Origin on the back foot and then they can send in Huni. He can dive out with his ultimate again. So very mobile fights, very tricky fights. And honestly, I want to see how the first 15 minutes pan out in this game.
Well, we are about to find out. The team comes locked in. It is time to load onto the Rift and decide who's number one in 2015.
Everything was working perfectly for them. I was thinking, damn, they actually play super good.
I think Origin's lineup is just incredibly strong. They have like top tier players on every role.
I think they really want to win, but I really want to win too.
You don't want to disappoint people.
Both teams are gonna try out a bit more.
I think it's going to be a really good match.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fnatic versus Origin. We're loading up onto the Rift. It is number one on the line. That is the spot. Whoever wins this will hold on to first place. And we see Origin with the first potential moves as they're grouping up towards the river. We may see some action here, gentlemen. Amazing. He's got a body slam in. He's found Fnatic. And we're off to an early start. Flash away. Yellow Stars taking a couple of those attacks. Reignover, he's thinking about it. He's got caught in place, though. Reignover's low. That's a summoner heal used from Reckless, and Fnatic are going
for
it. Huni gets a time winder, applies the slow. The death ray burns through amazing HP, but nobody's dropped yet. And this is the game we all wanted.
And right there, what happens very often in level ones is that teams, you know, they pan out, they have one guy sitting, waiting in that bush, they're amazing, their body slams over. So two things could happen for him. Either he finds the entire Fnatic team, quickly can flash out, or he finds a single guy alone, and they might force a flash away from him.
Fantastic start by both teams here, honestly. And then the brawl, it shows that neither teams were afraid to fight, because amazing, he body slammed back into that without his flash. So we talked about it earlier, about how he didn't want how he liked to take risks in the early game, how NA teams probably played a little bit too passive. And
that was a very high-risk situation, though. Just body slamming in instantly at
Why
number
not?
One.
He had flash. It was hashtag calculated. So Amazing's Gragas is going to be popping up. We'll see how well he can perform. So far, he's got a fantastic win ratio. A pretty impressive KDA, wouldn't you say, gentlemen?
Yes, very nice.
Definitely a confident player. Hooney, however, is caught out. Ethereals gets some damage down to him. Keep in mind, he's got no flash either.
Yeah, so let's look at early game here. Swords is running with the smite on the Hecarim. So Origin was setting up for that lane swap in pick and ban phase against the Echo, of course, and also trying to maybe dodge around the Kalista lane a bit for them. So not running Ignite for him. Instead, we're going to see the skirmishes, a bit more tanky focus from Source, but of course better now when he has the double jungle, potentially sit and try and get some farm in the bottom lane as well, that smite later on.
Also, it looks like Fnatic got caught a little bit off guard to the late swap, because Origin, they started on their weak side, moved to their strong side, and now they can invade Fnatic's weak side jungle again. So they don't get the three buff, but they do get a lot of camps here on the way, and then it'll probably translate into a 4v0. Reignover now spots, you know, say, okay, that buff is gone. So fantastic start by Origin.
Both teams pushing the bottom lanes here, so you have to send your junglers around it at least to be ready in case someone teleports in. But look here, four Fnatic. No, they're all coming down, so it's going to be the 4v0.
They almost changed up their plan. We saw a triple recall initiated by Origin. They wanted to flex it up a little bit, but then they decided, okay, let's not do that. It's too risky. We can get dove. Let's just go for the standard 4v0 and clean that top jungle.
Let's keep our eyes on Hooney, yet to pick up any CS or experience level 1. Currently to the 8 CS that Soaz has been able to pick up. I think Fnatic have got on this tower earlier than Origin did. However, the top half of the jungle has been invaded, as you touched on, Deficio.
Should be fine for them. Slowly, you just calculate, can we take the tower down? You know, if it's 20, 30 seconds after, it's not going to be a big deal. So they decide to take away a few camps. And what can go really wrong now here for Hooney is once he returns to top lane, if Origin bounces the wave correctly, it's going to push towards them and Hooney gets knight even more. But look what Fnatic is doing. They keep him bottom lane to get solo XP. So he's basically saying, you are really far behind. You're only level 1. We take Dragon, you get the farm and XP.
And this is what usually happens when the blue team initiates a lane swap and starts on their weak side. They get a lot more experience, get that up on their top laner. They traded tower for Dragon against just a tower, but they get a lot more experience. Soaz was 2 levels ahead of Hooney at one point. He has to catch up, and this was a crucial matchup in Origin against Fnatic.
And also just a jungle start for Amazing. He was on the weak side of the map. He took the red buff at level 1, and then he just ran out of that jungle to the top side. So there were 3 buffs coming in for Origin here. Fnatic caught a little bit off guard here early game. Hooney, now he gets level 2 for himself.
Very big wave to play with. Hooney's going to be very happy trying to play catch-up. Keep your eyes on the minimap as you see the lane setting, but I do want to highlight the fact that Febivin's Victor has got a small advantage over Pekka's Azir. Both of these players, first time on their respective champions this split.
Good early start for him, been trading really well. The death rate's not a matchup we see too often here in Europe, honestly, so I'm really looking forward to see what both of them can do.
Now, something I want to see Origin do is when they get this lead, this experience advantage, they should get Soaz in the top lane, play passive, move Amazing down to the bot lane and go for a 3-man plus teleport equals 4-man dive on Hooney and put him even farther behind. If they can do that, they can really snowball this game.
But even now with Fnatic sending Reckless to the top side, we see Hooney recalling. There's nobody on the bottom lane right now. All 5 members on the top side of the map.
Reignover's in trouble. He's eaten a barrel. Amazing's trying to get in. He should be able to make his way out, but there's support coming from all angles. We do see the Undertow connecting. Amazing's going to get interrupted. Doesn't connect with a body slam. Now, Origin, turn around. Reignover gets the Eye of the Storm help from Yellowstar. The stun catches onto Miffy. The parallel convergence holds him in place as Hooney is now in retreat. Yellowstar and Reckless, I think you're on the wrong side of the river. Force flash away as Yellowstar throws down Ignite. Hooney, he's come over the wall. He's going to get first blood on top lane Echo. Niels will reply as Amazing follows suit. 1 for Kalista, 2 for Niels. Reckless is now in trouble. Yellowstar's got nothing really to help with. Eye of the Storm shield will keep Reckless alive for a few more moments. Rend is going to get Niels to 100, but a spell shield is not going to work. Fnatic are winning this team fight. The knockup on Timothy as Reckless aggressively flashes for the kill, and they come out 4-for-1.
And Yanka said it in the feature. Origin against Fnatic is going to be a bloodbath, and a bloodbath it was. We were talking about the potential dive on Hooney. Fnatic read that. They say, we have no part in this. We're going to move over to the other side of the map. immediate brawl, and I'm just impressed by the way Reckless played that fight.
Yeah, let's see it again here. Replay starting. Both teams, they somewhat share the same playstyle. They're not afraid to take these early fights, so we're gonna see 5v5. Bot lane now, Source is gonna teleport in. And at first, you know, we just played a little bit, the two junglers dancing around, and suddenly everyone joins in. February first, great amount of damage.
Yeah, the tornado canceling, the body slam over here. This is the breaking point. Parallel conversion connects, and their teleport from Soas is just too late. With Soas on the bot lane, I feel like Origin could have disengaged here.
They could definitely just back the way. They didn't have to take the fight, but they want to play for these early kills here. That's how they snowballed. Failure was the plan for them. Reckless here now, securing a few kills. He's left almost untouched, and by now, Origin has already lost the fight.
Yeah, Huni got that first spot shield on Reckless here, but look how much balls are in this guy. He gets so low, but he knows he can win this fight. Pekka is out of mana, so he doesn't have much. Miffy doesn't have a stun, and he just keeps going, aggressing forward. And we've talked about Reckless being a passive player. Everybody's like, yeah, he's just leaning back. He's the second steal back, but he just showed he can go aggressive as well.
Yeah, 2-0-2 on Kalista. Head in CS, 7 minutes in. Cutlass, so he's instantly just gonna go play the Ruined King. He's gonna be so strong, and if he ever gets that 1v1 in these lanes here, he can just chase them down. So he's basically now looking for as much single target damage as possible.
And we have to step back and look at the rest of the map. Huni is now ahead in CS. We see the mid lane still in favor of Febivant. Reynov is the only one that's falling a little bit behind his opposite number. But both of these guys doing fantastic, fantastic work. We do see the duos now coming head to head, as Niels and Mithy will be doing battle with Reckless and Yellowstar. Take a look at your AD carry stats. Actually, Niels has a slightly higher kill participation than Reckless. He may continue that trend on Sivir this game.
Yeah, and talking on the other side of the map here, Huni still has his teleport. Teleport advantage for Fnatic in addition to that 2,000 gold lead.
It's very clear that Fnatic were ready to say, we can just rush in the top tower if you want to trade for the bottom lane. We don't need to leave Huni on his own here. So they send him top, and of course, in the end, because the fight then breaks out, they're very quick to react, move down, and join it in. So right now, both top lanes on the bottom side, a lot of people on the top lane here. Reynova's coming
Fate's
in.
Call. Fate's call, it's not gonna connect. Niels is gonna spell shield, but he gets knocked up by the Howling Gale. Reckless is continuing to go forward, and Reynova, he's gonna sink down the vicious strikes. Febivant gets the kill.
And look at where Febivant is, and then look at Xpeke. Another roam from Febivant where he arrives early. Fnatic is playing this game as a team. They just wanna group up all their members together, get these kills. Surprise Origin, and their vision wasn't sufficient.
No, they were just waiting for Origin to push down past the tower, tier 1 tower that died earlier, so they were too far up the lane. And then you have an Olaf there with the axe to land the slow. You throw in your Janna as well, and suddenly you can just chase them down, secure another kill. A lot of people talk about how Origin, they had to do well in the early game to beat Fnatic. This is not looking great for them, 9 minutes in at least, looking at the gold and the kills early on.
And the teamwork of Fnatic reflects in the stat, if you look at Yellowstar here, 5 assists out of 5 kills. Reckless involved in all 5 kills as well. Even though Fevin's in the mid lane and people don't usually talk about, you know, how these both mid laners are passive in regard, he's involved in 4 out of 5 kills already. So good start by Fnatic.
Definitely is. They've got the gold lead, they've got the lane lead, the kill lead. They've even got the fan vote lead. It doesn't really get much closer than that. 55%. I do want to highlight the fact that Fnatic have invested almost all of their resources into this duo lane. It's paid off with dividends. And Huni's not done too bad for himself. However, that small CS advantage has been evened out as Soas has had some time alone in the bottom lane.
Yeah, by Fnatic leaving Huni on the bottom side while they took the dragon, he managed to catch up at least a little bit and now even it out here. And looking at Origin's composition though, despite falling behind, they have a lot of ways to start some very explosive fights, but they require them to have some proper wards for the Hecarim to use, and Fnatic is doing a great job securing a very defensive line already.
I do like Origin's draft in that regard because they have a couple of what they call comeback mechanics. Even when behind, they can group up, pop on the hunt, and then flash Tibbers. I'm still waiting for Miffy to hit level 6, and then we could see another move from Origin. I hope Fnatic picks up the dragon before that, else it might be a very explosive fight yet again, but they have to focus Reckless.
Well, we did see very early on, once that first dragon fell, neither Fnatic or Origin have had a 5-dragon buff game yet. But considering dragon is up and Fnatic have numbers in the bottom lane and teleport, maybe today is the day they secure that. And also both of these supports start at Ancient Coin. So Amazing gets the body slam at the early Yellowstar.
Very early, yeah.
Maybe primitive Fate's call. Looney's gonna actually connect with the parallel convergence, but uses that one to get away.
So this is what we mentioned in champs, like how Hecarim can do pretty well in the trades because there's a melee champion he's against in Echo here. But what Huni can do is once you hit level 9, you get rank 5 of your Q, you get Morrel Nomicon, you can start instant clearing these caster minions, and you can fast push down the waves and then start roaming. And instead of trading with Soas, you might be able to join your team before him and not even use the teleport. And that's how Fnatic might be able to utilize Huni and roaming around, because they love to do it normally.
Yeah, Huni did equalize that experience disadvantage, but Miffy is getting closer and closer to level 6, and we might actually see Dragon 10 from Origin right after to come back into this game.
We'll find out if they opt to go that way, Crepo. Fnatic still 3,000 gold in the lead. Fnatic are the ones that have started this Dragon off. Huni's actually going to be able to recall before Soez can find him. It looks like Origin may be a little late to react. Going down.
It's low on mana.
Origin is coming in now.
Let's find out. Xpeke. He's going to call a Sand Soldier up, and he steals it. He's going to hop over the wall as Rainover goes down. Neils gets a kill. Onslaught of Shadows from Soaz. Huni and Reckless trying to peel away. We do see the storm coming down from Febivin. He's trying to siphon Origin's power. He puts it onto Soaz, but Soaz is still so alive. Febivin's now in trouble. Out of mana. Barrel down. He's dropped. Neils gets two more kills. Peke will lose his life in reply. But Origin stole the dragons.
Not over yet, Trevor here. Fnatic is behind enemy lines, and Origin, they're looking for them.
Well, let's see. Reckless is on Miffy. Amazing's on Huni. Where can Reckless get away? He's been stunned up. Neils is going to be able to get one to reply. And Yellowstar keeps him alive.
The Monsoon
saves Reckless's life. And Yellowstar, with his last drop of mana, secures the disengage.
2-for-2 in the end here, but Origin, they got the dragon. They were looking for a fight like this. He would come in with the Sivir ulti in the river. Flash tippers as well for Mythi and Fnatic. They started that dragon knowing that Origin had full vision of it.
I just love watching this game and the way these fights go down, because people don't back out fully. We see the dragon here. Peke eventually picks that up. It was 31 HP. This puts Rainover in an awkward position. So this fight's pretty much 4v5. However, they lose the Gragas ulti. I want you to keep an eye on Febivin later in the fight and the way he uses his cleanse, because he just immediately cleanses a stun, gets out of the stun, but then still ends up dying.
Yeah, he doesn't really have enough damage yet to flash in and try and blow up multiple people. He's still in the early game on this Victor. He goes down, but then we look at Huni and Reckless, how they take Peke now. I mean, it looks bad. Four members from Origin on their way. And then, of course, Yellowstar comes in the very end as well.
The aggressive play here from Reckless almost gets caught, but watching the bottom right of your screen, Yellowstar here, shield, and Monsoon knocks Neils back. So that's a displacement crowd control effect. In addition to that, it heals Reckless enough for him to escape. And then the zoning tornado to save Huni. Fantastic play by both these teams, and what a bloodbath.
Very much so. Very bloodbath indeed, Crepo. What I wanted to say, while the replay was going on, we did actually see red buff stolen from Fnatic. And if you have a look at the graph down on the bottom, average game times and average gold leads, Fnatic traditionally not as far ahead as Origin at the 15 and 20 minute marks. So Fnatic doing better than their records have suggested thus far.
Origin has been very good at really snowballing these early leads. They got two towers down. We mentioned earlier how Febivin was roaming from his lane to join in on certain ganks and fights, where Peke was just sitting mid lane. It now resulted in mid tower going down, the Sivir bot lane pushing in as well. No real wave clear from Reckless yet on this Sivir, or on this Kalista. So Origin getting some towers down, trying to even out the goal. It's very, very close still, and it's super explosive when you have the Annie, when you have the Hecarim from Origin side.
Yeah, we're definitely going to see an explosive mid-game here. Just if you look at both compositions, you can already spell out the way these teamfights are going to go. There's so much outplay potential on both sides, and I just like that they're not afraid to go for these plays. A lot of games, once you start losing people, once they're a man down, they decide to opt out of the fight. But we saw Fnatic, even though Rainover dropped early, they still had the confidence to fight. Gave up a couple of kills, but good micro plays in addition to good macro plays so far.
And we really have to see how Fnatic sets up for certain objectives, because when you're against, of course, this home guard Hecarim, you always have to respect the potential flank. You gotta have vision on the Annie as well, so you can see the flash tables coming. Yellowstar is the man to save Febivin and Reckless, while Rainover and Huni are diving the backline itself. So Fnatic will have to split up the composition somewhat, and that can be tricky to play if they don't have proper vision down when Origin pops everything they have.
Well, we've seen Fnatic pull it off thus far. They still maintain a lead, however, that gold lead has shrunk down to 1,000 from 3. I also want to highlight Neils and Reckless, still 100% kill participation for each of those 80 carries. You can really see where the teams are prioritizing their time, energy, and resources. As we've now sort of reset a little bit of the map, you can see Huni pushing out that top wave. He's got himself those Home Guard boots and Marilla Nomicon. CDR Echo build.
Tapping out top lane on the CDR for him. Of course, going to add a bit of wave clear. It's very important for him as well that he's going to be able to dive in with his E. He needs that extra, or the shorter cooldown on it, obviously, to stick to the likes of a Sivir. But it's funny with these two AD carries and how you mentioned them, Trevor, because whenever people were describing Nils before he became a professional player, they always said, yeah, he's just a new Reckless. Like, exactly the same. Great mechanics, good positioning. He's just a new Reckless. Now they're playing against each other, and they're the ones sitting on almost all the kills. And now we just have to see who can carry the hardest.
Well, we'll find out soon enough, I feel. A small lull, but it's Origin that's making the first invade. They've already secured the outer line of turrets. Fnatic unable to secure the outer mid turret from their opponents.
Origin just has a harder first engage, a primary engage on the Annie with the Flash Tibbers. It's just bigger than anything Fnatic can offer. They can throw in a Janna with Fade's Call, but it kind of CCs herself too, so the Tornado follow-up isn't that easy. So a lot more complex composition for Fnatic. But this game's been a bloodbath, but it's been a calculated bloodbath. Every fight has been with a goal in mind, mostly an objective. And this is what separates these teams from some of the teams lower in the standings.
It's very true. We have different things they can do. I really want to see for Fnatic then, with these fights, if it's about kiting at first. Because obviously Echo has massive amount of slows from different abilities, and that his W here, if you bait people in towards you, could be a way for Fnatic then to set up the fights. But once again, it's going to be tricky. Reckless aiming for the Hurricane build, so he's not going to be able to bust the big tanks with that effectively. But of course, there's so many members diving onto him, having that extra AoE damage.
Yeah, and
can be useful.
You make a solid point regarding the kiting and the disengage from Yellowstar with the Monsoon, and that's why, in addition to the on the hunt, Miffy's already building a Talisman of Ascension. He wants to get that extra
Storch and Enchant Maple Lady.
Yep.
Maybe later. I think I put them together.
You're thinking about your lady?
Maybe lady?
Maybe lady. But yeah,
maybe
let's see
lady
if this dragon fight is as explosive as the last.
Well, maybe Mithy's worth it after all. We did see a lot of poke applied to Huni as he has to phase dive away. But look at the poke that Peck is putting down. 0-1-3 down in CS 30 against Febivin, but need to see Large Rod and the Marillion Omicron.
I feel like Origin has a lot of better zone control, you know, with the likes of Azir, the Gragas engaged, the teleport threat from Soaz. I feel it's a lot harder for Fnatic to dance around Origin than it is for Origin to dance around Fnatic.
That's what we've talked about a few times now, how Fnatic can execute these fights here. And as we said as well before, if you want to move in towards the dragon, you need to know where the walls are behind you. You cannot give Soaz a perfect teleport opportunity. He's back in base now. He's waiting for that home guard.
Look at those soldiers zoning again. That's the zone control we were talking about.
You can't go in there. You just have to back away. If you walk in there as well, the Tibbers is just going to stun multiple members, and it's going to go horribly wrong for Fnatic.
Do you feel this goes back to the draft? Did Ducky outdraft Daylor here for the, which was a coach which we always talked about had one of the best drafting phases in Europe?
I think it's very clear that Fnatic wanted to try something different and maybe potential counters, but I'm not really seeing them right here. Again, the Rek'Sai was an option for you. They went for the Olaf fan off. Let's see what else they got here. They gave away so many power picks to Origin on their side, but we talked about how both AD carries, both jungles were open, so you could go for Hecarim and then still get one of the good picks.
So we'll find out if it works out for Fnatic. We just hit 20 minutes on the clock, and that gold lead continues to hover between the 1 and 2,000 amount. Do take a look at 20 minutes. Baron has spawned. It's probably very early in this game, but Fnatic over the last 6 games have put a lot more focus on that objective than Origin have.
Yeah, just different ways of snowballing the games. Fnatic is a little more calculated in their approach. Origin just really slaughters their enemies in most of the games. If they get ahead, they get ahead so far that they don't need objectives to close it out. But both teams so far seem very dragon focused. I think it's too early, like Quickshot said.
Yeah.
For the dragon, so I imagine, for the Baron Rider, so I imagine the game's gonna slow down and just have another third dragon coming in here. And that could be big for Origin because yet another move speed boost.
I also know that Fnatic is one of those teams who doesn't necessarily need to snowball in early lead to do well. They've been performing so well in the late game, even if they do fall behind, like you saw against SK Gaming, they came back in the game here. So definitely for them, it's not a bad situation. I mean, they're heading gold, obviously. They got a great amount of kills on Reckless. I want to see what happens though around the next fight.
Yeah, Fnatic are winning in CS for both Huni and Febivin by sizable margins. 43 is Febivin ahead. Peke not finding the CS that he necessarily wants. Around 30 for Huni in the top lane. But the game has slowed down. Once those outer towers fell, neither team is pushed into their opponent's base. And look at the defensive line of pink wards for actually from both squads on their respective strong sides of the map.
A lot of focus around the Baron itself. Mid tower is still alive. That's where Pekka is sitting on that Azir, just constantly wave playing and pushing out. And he never really leaves the lane. It's not have to do too much in this game.
It's not even alive. It's still on full HP. So that's full tower advantage here for Origin. Some aggression on the top lane.
Well, Reckless is going to be able to pull Yellowstar out if anything goes right. We do see Huni. He's gone aggressive. Parallel Convergence is shot out and it's not going to connect. He will find the shield, however. Timewinder trading back and forth and Chrono Break Ghost. Keep your eye on it. Not needed this time. We do see Huni backing away.
And Huni building for the split pushing here for the one-on-one. He's getting that Lich Bane second, so he's going to delay his Hourglass, which is going to be crucial in the big team fight, but of course he wants to be able to duel Soas down here in the bottom lane.
And Huni obviously playing a damage-oriented top laner, whereas Soas, he's building very tanky on that Hecarim, and this adds to the zone control. If you have double tank composition with an Azir, with an Anythread, it's so much harder for Fnatic to face around it. However, if things go right for Fnatic and things get explosive in their favor, then they have a lot more damage on their side of the team.
And if Fnatic hits a point where Huni can start beating Soas because he gets that mass amount of AP versus a full tank, that's where Origin suddenly is forced into big team fights. Then they can't hold him in the one-on-one like they're doing now. And suddenly, well, that would open up a way for Fnatic at least to apply pressure on the map. They're still waiting though for Huni to scale up a little bit. Lich Bane is now completed.
And we'll find out how effectively he can use that Lich Bane. I do want to take a brief moment to talk about Reignover and his limited impact in this game. 0-2-1 from what many, including myself, consider to be one of the strongest, if not the strongest jungler in Europe. This Olaf pick is just not showing up. Rek'Sai was available. Admittedly, the lane swaps factor in, but I've yet to see this Olaf pay dividend for the team.
But it's very hard to play an Olaf as a single tank in your composition, because your job usually in fights is to get so tanky that you can threaten the backline by running into them, and they can't afford to waste time killing you, but you can't get crowd controlled, so peeling is so hard. But he doesn't have another tank, you know, holding the front. He kind of has the disengage from Janna, so it, again, it makes it very complex for him to do. But later on in the game, I want to see if he gets super tanky, whether he can keep Niels busy on his own.
That's gonna be
the crucial point.
Yeah, that's gonna be his job. I mean, Olaf is one of these champions who can't really do anything else than just go that one way, because if you try and kite and you throw your axe, you can't go and pick it up again. There's a fairly long cooldown suddenly. So it's definitely gonna be him dealing with Niels in these fights here, saying, you know, Mithy, I don't care about your CC, I'm gonna get to this AD carry and just single him out every single time.
Well, we have to highlight the fact Fnatic are the ones that are applying pressure. We saw Huni hammering away on the bottom lane in a turret. We've seen Fnatic on the top half pushing the waves into Origin and continually dictating the tempo of the map.
And this is what we've seen with this Huni, this Echo into Hecarim matchup, is Huni can always just instant push out the waves. He can trade pretty effectively now with some items, so he's trying to at least force Soas to play very defensive now. A stun onto Niels, maybe.
Niels is in trouble. Timewinder's gonna come backwards. Huni does get the burst. He's not gonna find the Chrono Break yet. Phase Dive, I think, got Spell Shield on the way. It's Reignover that gets the kill. Huni pieces out of the fight with the ultimate, and Reignover's Ragnarok gets him out clean.
And there's no wards in the river here from Origin, so once the bot lane was pushed out, Huni just sneaked his way in there. Niels did not expect it. 20 seconds. Fnatic might just force a Baron and even take a fight if Origin walks in to stop it.
Well, remember, 10 Barons up until this point. Fnatic oftentimes secure those early ones. They have a numbers advantage for another 10 seconds. So missing some key ultimates. Ren is starting to be stacked up. Origin are well aware of this, and Niels has only just spawned. Look at the damage onto Yellowstar, though. Soez is coming in with the onslaught of Sharaz. Baron is going low. Explosive glass comes out. It's secured by Huni. Fnatic get the first Baron of the game, and now the team fight continues. Reckless forced to flash defensively as Soez gets cut down where he stands. Feathervin siphons Peke's power. He's going to stun up amazing, and Huni gets his fourth kill of the game. There's the phase dive forward. He Chrono breaks out, and Peke almost gets taken out.
And this play here, everything was just set up from Huni being able to push that bottom lane. Roam mid, get a pick onto Niels, who didn't expect it, and you start that Baron instantly, even against double smite from Origin. Fnatic takes it, they win the fight, they get another dragon, so even out 2-for-2.
This is probably the most value I've seen out of a single pick. Immediate reaction by Fnatic. Even though Dragon was up in 30 seconds, they move to the Baron pit, they know they have the disengage, and more importantly, they know they have the smite secure mechanic. However, things go a little awry, because eventually Huni is the one that ends up picking Baron, but the second they have it, you know, their job's done. They can even drop a couple of members, it's enough, and Origin used all their offensive tools to try and steal that Baron. Once they get out of that fight is just pretty much over for them. And then it snowballs into another dragon, and yeah, such a crucial pick. I almost feel like a big mistake from Niels getting caught there in the mid lane. 30 seconds to dragon. I feel that's not supposed to happen.
Well, it did happen, and that means Origin are now 5,000 gold down. This game that looked so even is now heavily in Fnatic's favor. Fnatic looking to stamp their authority on this matchup, and what a great confidence.
Yeah, and it's all these small things these individual players can do that just makes it so hard when you face a team like Fnatic, because suddenly Huni makes a quick move and it just turns the game around completely. As you said yourself, Krepo, I mean, Nils staying on his own so far out, but you have both your summoners, you have a spell shield as a Sivir, you probably feel super safe to just take one more wave. Ended up costing him a lot though.
Yeah, and this is why Fnatic is lauded as probably the best team in the European LCS right here, because all they need is that one pick immediately, zero hesitation, move over to the Baron. Other teams may have just postured for the Dragon, tried to slow the game down, make it two Dragons to two, but good game read here. Fantastic shot calling by Yellowstar, and we said it earlier, who's going to be the best leader?
This to be Yellowstar. Baron empowered minions as well as the team fight advantage. Fnatic press home that mid outer turret. How much can they gain from this Baron buff? That's what we'll look at. A lot of wave clear to get through between Azir, Sivir, and Gragas. Maybe Origin can dig deep and defend, but they're going to be hard pressed to do so.
First, the last outer turret finally down for Fnatic, so they really open up the entrance into the Origin jungle, where it suddenly becomes a lot easier now moving in and securing the vision to go back to split pushing, because again, with Huni here getting stronger and stronger, and Source, of course, building full tank, has to even go for some armor because he has to respect the damage of Reckless. The one-on-one is in Huni's favor at the moment. And Fnatic needs to play around that. You always see him in the side lane.
It's definitely working out. Fnatic maintaining control of the tempo. He's touching the items very quickly. We did see that Mikhail's Crucible picked up the Yellow Star to help defend against Mithy. To see Pekka throwing down the tower to defend behind, but I think they're going to get pinched in.
He's
going to be in trouble. There's the parallel convergence. There's the shield on Huni. The Emperor's Divide is going to block Fnatic out, and the escape mechanism worked, but teleport advantage will fall to Fnatic in a few seconds' time. So as TP'd in for that one.
So just to talk about that play here, Origin had Amazing and Source down on the bottom side because they were expecting that Source had to teleport away. Amazing walked away as well though, so Regis will secure the tower. But Origin right here, it looked very risky, but they very clearly had a plan of how to get out. They put up their Zeer turret, they walk into the jungle and just put up the wall to deny Fnatic from ever getting in there, and just got a bit of damage from mid tower.
And this is obviously the bane of a Sivir composition, usually is 1-3-1, because you cannot afford to just split up because you want to group, you want to use that on the hunt. That's what Origin did before that 1-3-1 got put in motion by Fnatic. They wanted to siege the tower, potentially get a pick, but their flanks weren't warded appropriately. Rushed into that decision, and good capitalization by Fnatic, because Huni can always dive in,
yeah,
because he can always corner pick back out, and that's the big crucial point.
And this teleport is so huge for Origin, because what they basically have to do at this point here is have four members together, have Source try and hold Huni or some defend a little bit against him, maybe try and push out the wave just a little bit, and then teleport in, pop that Sivir ulti with the four members from Origin, and get the big team fight. Don't allow Huni to sit and split push, because then you're simply just gonna slowly but surely lose it. Now with teleport down, that's not gonna happen for a few minutes.
And we'll find out if it affects Origin's playstyle. What we've seen from them, regardless of their lead or deficit, Origin tends to play very aggressive. They tend to be very proactive in looking for team fights. They're very far down as we've reached 30 minutes. And the game Origin lost to Rocket, they were still looking for team fights despite not having a strong enough lead to actually win them.
And we saw Fnatic earlier in the game run out of steam in a couple of these fights, but look at the itemization coming out of Febiven and Huni. It's full damage. Amazing going in.
Well, let's see. Tower is being chunked down. Eye of the Storm from Yellowstar will keep the tower alive. On the Hunt has been used from Niels, and Reckless continues to push a side lane.
And this itemization ups the value from Yellowstar's Monsoon and Crucible. He just needs to keep his carries alive, and Fnatic will snowball from that.
And right there, from Fnatic side, putting Reckless in the side lane to 1-3-1, it was pretty risky, but Origin had the chance to engage and they missed it. They didn't get anything from it. Reckless gets to push down the wave here, and suddenly Fnatic does not get punished for not having 4-5 members around that mid lane.
And this is the second time it happens. First with Soas' teleport, now with Amazing's flash. Neil's also used On the Hunt, so we talked about those comeback mechanics from Origin, but they have to use them properly if they want to catch Fnatic, and they're playing with enough respect to not throw this game, throw their lead away. They're calmly waiting for the next objective, and again, it's going to be around this dragon. Third dragon for both teams.
20 seconds for that one, 40 seconds for Baron. Fnatic, I think all split long, they've had near flawless Baron plays. You seldom see Fnatic making mistakes around that objective. But we do see Origin with some position in the river, and they've denied vision from Fnatic.
Yeah, I like this position here from Origin. Finally, they get a bit of control before the objective even spawns. But look at what Fnatic is doing. Saying, we don't want to walk in and risk face checking you, so we push down the mid lane and force you to leave this objective and walk in towards us so we can now get a chance to move back into the dragon, clear these pink wards you just had placed there, and get down our own wards. That's how you very quickly remove someone from an objective.
Yeah, and good zone control doing so. They put Rain over in the front, so Mythy can't afford to get close there. They have the parallel convergence zoning out as well. But we see a fight here.
Well, it does look like it. Parallel convergence holds Soaz in place, and Huni has found Pekka. Emperor's Divide is going to lock them out, at least for a moment, as Rainover is Ragnaraking around, but he can't find anyone. The rest of Fnatic did not follow through, and now they're peeling away. Chrono Break was also used by Huni in their team fight. So Fnatic get the dragon, but don't lose anything in reply.
And Origin couldn't set up a proper fight for themselves here. Didn't have close to teleport from Soaz instead. Backs away, so fine for them, honestly. In this case, it's so hard to do anything when you have to walk into Fnatic. You already lost that position. You're still waiting for that summoner spell. You might be able to secure mid tower at least. It was very low from before.
I just love watching the setup of these fights, even more than the fights themselves, but you can see what's going on in the minds of Fnatic. They say, okay, Miffy on Flash Tibbers, that's a threat. So we put Rain over in the front. If he gets stunned, he can always Ragnarok out. We want Huni to flank. Wants to go in.
Well, he is going in. Parallel convergence will not connect.
But they have the zone control on the Baron.
Let's see. Fnatic once again bully their way in front of the objective. We did see Talisman of Ascension used from Mythi. He still has Flash and Tibbers available. He's leading the way.
Neil
may get caught out. We do see nobody from Fnatic diving in. Look at Baron HP in the bottom left, guys. Fnatic are on track to get number two, and they do.
You have the Kalista there. Timing with the true damage of an Olaf and his own smite, and you secured that one. Once again though, this is the setup for Fnatic, how they zone Origin away from these objectives, and then they just brute force them down.
Just keep your eyes on Huni as well, as Yellowstar approaches Soaz. Looks to put the pony in the stable. Knock up slow. A lot of hunting going on here. Reckless is gonna hop over, eventually go down. While we see Soaz die, I just wanna go back to that point for Huni. The way he uses his clone, I'm just gonna let that breathe. It's just fantastic. So he walks into the choke point when Origin is not there, then he walks out, and Origin can still not walk in because then Huni can simply throw down parallel convergence and proc the chrono break to go back in. And yeah, look at Soaz on your player cams. He's not a happy camper right now.
He's definitely not. 0-3-1. He's down just shy of 100 CS. Pekka down 90 CS. 80-90 against Febivin. Origin are tested individually this game, and they seem to be faltering in the top and mid lane positions. Niels is the only player that seems to be doing well, but it's wave clear on Sivir, of course. He's going to back that one up. Fnatic now pressuring this mid inner tower.
So we talked about how it was going to be Huni against Soaz, and it ended up being Huni getting that pick here, but Mythi?
Well, Reckless is going to get stunned, but he flashed just before Mythi could hold him in place.
Mythi didn't really use anything. The Talisman is 40 second cooldown. So I guess, yeah, he used that ability, but didn't have to flash for it. Force the Wraith for Reckless. That could be an opening for Origin. If Soaz gets in from the flank, onto Reckless.
Reckless is caught out. He's been stunned. We see the Mikhail's coming out, but look at the reply. Origin locked up against the wall. Soaz will go down to the rend of Reckless, and they're running away. Emperor's Divide knocks Yellowstar back as the boomerang from Niels doesn't really connect. Tower falls, inhibitor falls. Fnatic have broken Origin's backs.
And again, Fnatic here, they know exactly what Origin wants to do. Soaz came from the base as well. They jumped Reckless. But you have the Mikhail's, you have the Janna there to help. And also Huni putting up this stun.
He's done it! Pekka gets stunned by the convergence, but Niels gets the crit that he wants. Reckless with one more. Three members of Origin down. Four members of Origin down. Niels trying to run away, and Fnatic unable to find him. Baron empowered minions and a numbers advantage. They're on to the Nexus. Fnatic will be undefeated at 7-0 if they can kill the Nexus.
Eventually. All right, Deficio, take it away.
What this shows, by the way, is Fnatic learned against Unicorns of Love. Don't bite off more than you can definitely chew.
is true. That is true. Quite a game from last split. Now, we just talked about that last fight here, how they knew the engage was going to be on Reckless. You have the Janna pick from Yellowstar. Because Fnatic has got such a good lead through some great plays, like both individually but also as a team, they've really shown how, oh, Origin, you want to try and set up a dragon, we know exactly how to zone you away from it. Mm-hmm. And they play around that same with the Baron. And Simply Windows, this comp here for them, I mean, Huni has been so fed and so has Reckless.
I just watch that again. Reckless has no flash, but doesn't really need that if Yellowstar can just flash in. This was actually later than that. We saw Huni go in, gets a stun, trades his life. But look at Reckless. Because he has that Runal's Hurricane, he can keep jumping and resetting his slow every time. Usually when you proc that Ren, he goes on cooldown. But because you have that Runal's in a minion wave, you end up killing one or two minions every time and it immediately resets. Keep hopping, keep going. And at this point, the lead is it's almost insurmountable. And I think it all goes back to that one play from Huni, that one pick on Niels.
Yeah,
snowball for Fnatic. That was a fantastic pickoff.
It was something we had mentioned, again, with how this Echo, once you get some AP, you start pushing out these waves very quickly, and then potentially roam around, and it happened for Huni. That was a big deal for them, and Fnatic not really looked back ever since.
So decisive.
Zero hesitation from Fnatic. But they played a little safe now, didn't go for that Nexus despite having the numbers advantage. We see that Banshee's Veil was picked up a minute or two ago from Reckless, so some safety in his side. With Dragon on the spawn in 25 seconds, Fnatic looking to pull Origin towards them.
And this is the problem when you play like any support and you get to the late game, when the supports start picking up Mikael's Crucible, when people get tanky enough that just one Tibber stun is not enough to blow people up, then the value again of that Monsoon goes up, because right now, Yellowstar, he has the shield from the Locket. He has the heal from the Monsoon, another shield of himself. Rainover is super tanky. He's running Havoc in the front. And Origin, yeah, they're running out of steam almost in these fights, mostly due to the gold lead that Fnatic has.
So Dragon easily secured. No contest from Origin. They're just trying to wave clear. So it's pushed out top lane as we see both Peke and Niels doing defensive duty down bottom.
We've seen Huni as well. He's the build here. We talked about the second item, Lich Bane, for the 1-1 potential. The latest Hourglass is going to come in as most likely the last one. I'm not expecting a Luden's Echo, even though it is a fine item on Echo for himself. But the way he's just playing the fights, he's always using his ulti defensively to get out.
Fnatic rush against Fnatic.
This might be in trouble. So as he initiated this one, he throws down the Onslaught to Shadows and Huni gets split up. He's used an early Chronovake to survive as Mythi now needs to flash defensively. Fnatic are not going to get Fnatic brushed, and they set up another tower kill.
Yeah, Soaz goes back in time, takes a play out of that book, wants to hide in the brush, but eventually Huni goes back in time and heals back up, so nothing ends up happening. Nice try, but that's what all they can do right now. Hail Marys, almost.
Really see the respect there from Fnatic. I mean, very few teams in Europe are able to fall this far behind and still stay in the game. Fnatic is clearly respecting Origin a lot, saying we want to take it slow, we want to maybe secure another Baron before we go for a last push. We don't want to risk a bad team fight that could then give Origin a chance to come back.
Fnatic potentially making a statement with this victory. We will not make mistakes. They want to prove they're the best team, and we've heard all of the hype, we've heard all the players. There's a lot at stake here between Yellowstar in particular and Reckless, considering, you know, their opponents.
But they can afford to play it slow because they definitely have the scaling. Huni, as we said earlier, against Soaz. Soaz playing that disruption tank later in the game is just not going to do enough. Whereas Huni, he's sitting on 720 AP with 40% CDR. He can just do so much in these fights. Yeah. Whereas Soaz is limited to that one dash, that one engage, that one ultimate. If that doesn't stick like we saw earlier.
Huni wants blood. He's just picked up Hourglass. He's got teleports. Gonna pull the trigger yet. Look at Rainover's positioning.
Here he goes.
Here's the TP.
It is starting. He's gonna come flying around the corner. He's gonna throw down Parallel Convergence. It doesn't connect a stun. He doesn't need it because he's down. Huni gets the kill before he gets dropped though. One for one. Rainover's wrecking Niels's face in the back line as Reckless gets a kill onto Amazing. Two members of Origin down. Only one for Fnatic. Siphon Power plus Rainover's Vicious Strikes will secure a kill or two for Fnatic. four members down. Only Neil Static, Fnatic, gonna look towards the Nexus.
8-0-9 on Reckless, involved in 17 out of 19 kills for Fnatic, and he's showing up big against his ex-teammates.
He definitely is. Fnatic put on a fantastic performance. The original fan favorites. They will take down Origin and hold on to first place, undefeated in the summer splits. That game delivered. Despite how heavily it ended, you can see how even they were, at least for the first 10, 15, 20 minutes.
Let's go back to level one. We had a big 5-on-5 team fight. A few minutes later, we have another one. That was the first big advantage for Fnatic when it secured 3 or 4 kills. Reckless got quite a few of them on his side. Origin tried to come back around the Dragon, but then we had that Huni roam into the mid lane, and just a few big plays really snowballed this advantage for Fnatic.
And just the way these fights came about as well, both teams were not thinking in the moment. They were both thinking 1 or 2 steps ahead, because we were talking about Huni. He had to get out of that bot lane because he could potentially get dove by Origin. So he backed up and joined Origin. They knew Huni might not even fall for that. So both teams ended up converging on the left side of the mid there in that explosive bloodbath.
Yeah.
And it just worked. It was smart fights. It wasn't senseless fighting, you know, not Unicorns of Love style almost some of these games. Everything happened with a goal. First, just control the map, later on the Dragons, later on the Barons, and fantastic playing and shot calling, honestly, from Fnatic.
And we didn't talk too much about him in the game itself, but Febiman on this Victor here, out farming Peke in the laning phase. Then he was roaming around, so yes, he lost his tower, but he added more value in terms of the kills he got. This Victor into a Zeer matchup, as I said in Champions League, from what I, when you talk to mid lane, say it can be a bit tricky because, you know, the soldiers can be super annoying for you, but he outfarmed Pick in this lane and got late game on the Victor, became a monster as well.
Definitely the case. You can see how happy Fnatic are, 7-0. And it's good to see some gentle smiles on the side of Origin. They did put up a good fight. I do want to highlight very quickly, 6 kills for Origin, all 6 of them in Niels' hands. Of the 19 kills Fnatic got, 17 of them Reckless was involved in. However, for the first time in summer, you can look at Niels and say there was a mistake. Whether or not it was lack of vision, whether or not it was just being in the lane, whatever the cause was, that's the first time we've looked at Niels and said, hey, there was a, you made a boo-boo.
And that's all right, honestly. He's an amateur player entering the LCS, fantastic performance so far, MVP, yeah. OP5, yeah. And just playing fantastic so far.
I agree 100% for him.
Well, we'll have to find out how well they can do. For now, we're going to throw it on to Pyrotechnics, who's standing.